and see the machines close up, hear the machines close up, and frankly get the real feel of what motorsport is all about, both past and present.
Delwyn's Porsche has had its fair share of admirers.
It came from France. I found it over here. Someone was being posted to, a journalist was working over here for a couple of years, and I found it on the road in Chiswick.
Tell me what it is about the shape of this that has made it quite so iconic.
Well, I think it's partly because it's fitness for purpose. It's a Bauhaus principle car, very simple. There's no excess ornamentation on it, and therefore it's fairly timeless. Are you reeling in the years, stowing away the time? Are you gathering up the tears?
Have you had enough of mine? Yeah.
Back in the workshop, our replica is still in bits. The team are building the car onto the floor pan of an old Beetle.
The floor pan is a bit on the flimsy side, so we're going to strengthen it up with this, which is a fully galvanised steel subframe.
The subframe will act as a skeleton to support and strengthen the overall structure of the car.
We're in.
Once it's fitted, it needs to be bolted in position.
When it's ready, this speedster will be easy to maintain and great fun to drive. But sports cars are not just for the boys. I don't care if the sun don't shine, I get my lovin' in the evening time when I'm with my baby. It's no fun with the sun around, but I get going when the sun goes down and I meet my baby. London stockbroker Lucy first saw a Porsche Speedster up on the big screen.
I first saw one on Top Gun. Kelly McGillis is driving one in that. And I always liked the car, and I, you know, had no idea that you could actually buy a new one that was the same.
She bought her ready-built Speedster replica for £22,000 last year.
Tell me how you came across it.
I took my father to the car show at Earls Court about 3 years ago, I think. Took him to look at some of the cars, and I was looking for a new car at the time, and I saw this one. I picked up a picture of it from the car show, and I had it above my desk for a couple of years, saying to all of my colleagues, well, I'm going to get one of these at some point in the future. And then, of course, I couldn't not get one. And when I saw this, I just thought, great. And the thing about it is, it looks like an old car, but it's not an old car. Sometimes it's quite embarrassing, actually, because I forget that I've got such a nice car. And you just want to go out normally and do a bit of shopping and what have you. Most people are quite confused as to what the car is because they recognise the style of the car, but the number plate doesn't fit the date, which they think it probably would be. And obviously it doesn't have any Porsche badges on it. I've come back to find people under it, people looking into it, people standing around it waiting for me to come back so they can ask me what it is. I really love driving the car. I think it looks beautiful. Its lines are fantastic. It just looks really sexy, I think. It just makes me happy. It's very weird when you're driving down the street and everyone's smiling at you. But it makes me smile.
In the workshop, our own Porsche replica is ready for its 15-inch shiny chrome-plated wheels.
They're not the easiest wheels to fit these because they don't have studs to sit on, so if you're on your own on the side of the road, you're guaranteed to get dirty.
Once the wheels have all been fitted, we have ourselves a rolling chassis. Next, we can start on the body.
It's a lot lighter than the subframe, isn't it?
It's important to test fit the fiberglass body prior to its paint job to make sure everything fits.
Just come in behind these posts, yeah? There we go!
With the body on, it's starting to look the part for the first time.
Our mob of mechanics are building a modern kit car replica of a 50s Porsche Speedster. They've built up the rolling chassis, fitted the gearbox and engine, and test-fitted the body panels. It's ready to hit the paint shop. The colour we've gone for is, in fact, a rather retro, mellow yellow. Now the bodywork's been painted, the team can fit the panels properly, starting with the doors. But there's a trick to it.
When you fit it, there's a recess. You can see that it doesn't actually fit. And to cure it, we pack it out using spacer washers. At the moment, I'm just guessing, just trying to build it up to get it somewhere close, just by how much it's out. We'll try it again. That's not so bad. That lines up better.
Every panel must be fitted precisely to avoid any damage to the paintwork.
So when that's down and this is up a bit, that'll improve the gap. Should we just tighten it up a little bit so we've got... The reason for paying such great attention to this gap is obviously from a looks point of view, but also if this is too tight here, when you lift the lid up, it'll just chip all the paint off this edge.
The aerodynamic shape designed by Porsche was way ahead of its time. Its early critics said it looked like an upside-down bathtub or even a jelly mould, but it didn't stop some people from falling in love at first sight.
Nice one. There isn't a flat piece of bodywork on this car. It is curves everywhere, and you really appreciate that most when you're sitting here in the driver's seat. You can tell that this car is a blood relative of the VW Beetle, and compared to a lot of the cars that were available in the 1950s, it is so curvaceous, which means it's really aerodynamic, and it just looks fantastic.
When Tony and Joan Tucker went on holiday to Dorset, the last thing they expected was to buy a car. They stumbled across a little factory.
I took one look at it. It was just the most beautiful car I have ever seen. My knees went weak.
I thought, this is more than just a look. I thought, I'm just not going to look here. I think we might be buying one of these. Just had that feeling.
Very smitten, they took one out for a test drive.
So I drove it along the coast road, above Chesil Beach, looking down at the sea. Air-cooled engine, open-top car, absolutely beautiful.
I thought, yeah, we're going to have this. What excuse is he going to make to buy this car?
Drove it back into Peter. He said, what do you think? I said, Peter, here's my chequebook. I didn't even negotiate. I mean, I just paid him what he was asking for it. I must have been off my mind. But that's what a car like that can do to you. You put your foot down, there's plenty of oomph in the car, and it just sails. And it's like flying. You feel like you're a bird. You're ghosting along this road, silver machine underneath you. What else is there? You know, that's life. I think I probably followed the George Best dictum when he was asked what happened to all his money. He said, well, 90% I spent on women and booze, and the other 10% I wasted. And I probably felt a bit like that with the Speedster.
I feel a bit like royalty when I'm in it because you sort of, people wave at you and they stop and look at you and ask what it is.
When I was single, I had sports cars, several, ending up with a gorgeous MG TF 1500. Joan had a Spitfire before we got married, open top. So when we got married, we switched them for an MG Midget. And when the family came along, we went into boring saloon cars, but kind of thought one day we might have a sports car again.
The children of both been through university, sort of about to leave the nest, I suppose, not quite, but more or less. And yes, looking for things that we perhaps need to do together more. It's quite hard to do that when you've been married as long as we have.
After 30 years of marriage, the car has given them a new lease of life.
It's taking us back to our youth in terms of open motoring, like we were when we had sports cars, and it's just great.
Certainly don't argue about who's driving, because Tony just loves driving it. So I love sitting in it, so for me it's very romantic because I haven't got to do any of the hard work. We tend to go out together more when we're in it, don't we?
Yeah, we go out together more probably.
I think we do.
Because it's fun to get to places, not just to get there, it's fun getting there because it's great driving the car there.
I get a buzz being able to go out in the car, I have to say. But yes, it's definitely a shared interest, and being able to go on holiday in it is super.
I think it's the best car in the world, and of course I've got the best wife in the world as well, so what more do you want?
In our own Speedster workshop, our team are raiding the kit